trucks all fitted together.
Mm-hmm.
But he would take a couple pieces of walnut in his suitcase,
mm-hmm.
and he would carve a postcard out, and they actually went through the mail.
Oh, wow.
And he even carved a little note on the backside.
Amazing.
Yeah. So it's just
it's just beautiful.
Mm-hmm.
Thank you so much.
Display the steel mill if they want to catch that.
Oh, yeah. You folks wanted, at the age of 14, Ernest worked at the steel mill, so the band's going to turn that on for you there.
Oh, okay.
And then this is his original workshop. You can come back out and look at this.
Okay.
He's going to turn on the mill. And Van will tell you about that. There you go.
Thank you.
Yeah. Thank you.
The best viewing is kind of right over here on this rail over here. A few minutes talking about this. Now, this steel mill is an exact mock-up of the steel mill that Mooney used to work in for 21 and a half years. So he wanted to carve his steel mill, and he ended up carving five of them. This one he carved, this is number four, and this is number five. They're all out of walnut and ivory. Took him roughly about 9 months to carve one of them. So he gets better and better as he carves them. This is, like I said, number five. But all these gentlemen, first I want to turn it on for you. You can look in the mirror down below and see how he came up with all the parts and pieces to make his steel mill have motion. But all these gentlemen on this board all have faces and names that actually match the gentlemen that he worked with. This guy right here, I'm sitting on the wagon, his name is Johnny Stutz, and Johnny Stutz is sitting here eating his Swiss cheese and his rhubarb pie. There's the foreman of the plant over there. He's slamming his fist down on his hand, and he's yelling at Henry inside the fenced area there. He's falling asleep all the time, so he has to come over and yell and wake him up all the time. The guy back there in the coal bin, his name is Patrick Murphy. And Patrick Murphy, you can see his hand come up to his mouth. And it was actually permitted back in the day that if you worked in the coal bin, you could actually drink buttermilk to keep the coal dust out of your throat. But everybody knew that buttermilk was probably at least 90 proof. So Mooney decided to carve himself in this steel mill. And that's Mooney right there on the left part of the shears. He's head shearman. And that's his best buddy, actually John Richards. And he actually became his brother-in-law later in life. It's pretty neat though, huh? You know, we've had to replace some pulleys and some belts and so forth over the years, but for the most part, this thing's been running really well.
Everything's in details.
Huh?
Everything is in details.
Detail, yes. It's one thing you'll notice about Mooney. He's very a detailed person. He loved to carve things small. The smaller, the better for him. And, he just loved to put details in. Well, I'll let you guys go ahead and finish reading about this room here. And then when you get ready and you go into the theater here, come get me and I'll turn the theater on for you then. Yeah.
Guns made of ivory.
Yeah. It's an ivory. That is an ivory.
is made of ivory.
Mm-hmm. Ivory.
Mm-hmm. You did this one with a chainsaw.
Yeah.
Nice. Mm-hmm. Pacific. Here's the ivory room.
Inside.
Mm-hmm.
I like this kind of carves. You know, like carving. I like